morning, one and all. In last lecture, we have seen the Taylor's method. If you have given numerical on Taylor's method, then how to solve that numerical with the help of Taylor's method we have seen in yesterday's lecture. Today, we will go on the next second method, how to solve that ordinary differential equation with the help of Taylor's method. This is the second method. You can solve the given differential equation with the help of Taylor's method. We'll see the details. First, see, you have given the equation, differential equation. Okay. This equation is a dy by dx is equal to f of x, y. Okay. This you can solve the first order equation only with the help of Euler's method. See, in this graph, I have plotted the graph y axis was y versus vx. Okay. Here is a equation of curve. I have drawn this curve. Then see, you have given the initial point x0 and y0. X0 and y0. I have given the name of that point is a P. What is the coordinates of that point? X0, y0. This is the initial value. You have given x is equal to x0 and y is equal to y0. That is P x0, y0. Okay, that is P x0, y0. Then we want to find the next point value. Next point I have considered here is a x1 and here is a y1 point. Then I have given the name of that point, Q is there. X1, y1 is the coordinate of that point. Then for next value of the x1 and y1. Okay, we want to find at a distance h, x1 at a distance h, then we want to calculate the value of y1, where h is the step size is given. Okay, then how to calculate that value y1? If we know the value of x1, then how to calculate the value of y1? Okay, this we can solve with the help of, or we can calculate it by Euler's method. Okay, are you ready? In second graph, check that. According to the Euler's method, we appropriate the curve. See here, according to that Euler's method, we are appropriate the curve. Okay, this curve. And the initial value of that curve, x0 and y0. Then here is the coordinate of that point P, x0, y0. What I will do, I have done here, I have drawn the tangent to the P point. I have drawn the tangent of the P point. And what happens when you extend that tangent and I have drawn the next point, x1 is known. Okay, I have drawn the perpendicular to the x-axis and this curve is cut. We can say the equation of curve is cut to the Q point. Then we get the new coordinate x1, y1 is the coordinate of the Q point. Again we are extend up to the tangent, then you will get the new point y1. Okay, this gap in between the two intersect point Q and y1, this is called as a error. Okay, and this error is called as a truncation error. We want to reduce that error. Okay, if the h step size is a maximum, then we can reduce the error. Okay, or we can minimize the error. Okay, all of you getting? Then next, we'll see the example with the help of Euler's method. How to solve the given example with the help of Euler's method? Yes, all of you getting this one? I will erase. Then see, finally we are we have got the first point distance y0 and second point distance is a L is there. Up to this P point to the Y1 point. Then we can find out the Y1 is equal to Y0 plus L. Y0 plus L. We can use the trigonometry and find out the final formula. For the this formula is called as the Euler's formula. Y1 is equal to Y0 plus H f of x 0 y 0. Again, what is the f of x y? Dy by dx. This is the differential equation. You should remember that only one formula. Which formula? Y1 is equal to y 0 plus h x 0. Okay? Got it? Then see how to solve the given numerical with the help of different steps. Okay, I will explain that steps. First, step number one. Before going on the step number one, see which is the given data or what is given in problem statement. Yes, anybody? What is the given in problem statement? Can you tell? Given, first check that dy by dx function is given, is equal to, we know that we have seen in the table series, fx y is equal to x minus y square. This is the differential equation is given. For the given boundary condition that at x is equal to 0, at x 0 is equal to 0, and I will write y is equal to y 0 is equal to again 0. Both value have given the 0. Find y at x is equal to 4. Okay, when x is equal to, we can write x t is equal to, boundary condition as given, x t is equal to 4, then y t is equal to how much? We want to the calculate. Take step size, h is equal to 1. Okay, step size, h is equal to 1 is given. Then before going on that, we want to the calculate number of steps. Number of steps. And how to calculate in the step number 1? Step number 1. Okay. We want to calculate the number of steps. Okay. How to calculate that number of steps? Yes. Anybody? It is denoted by the n. N is equal to, there is a formula, xg minus x0 divided by h. We know that. What is the value of xg? Xg is given 4, x0 0 divided by 4. Again, you will get the 1. Means here, you have to calculate, you will get the different iteration. But you have to use their formula for that, sorry, x is equal to 1 is there. 1 is there, sorry. And here is the 4. Check that, h is equal to 1 is given. Then you will get the 4. Means you will get the number of equation is a 4. Okay. This 4 is indicated that you will get the number of iteration is 4. Or you have to use the Euler's formula 4 times. Euler's formula 4 times. Then step number 2nd. Step number 2nd. What is the step number 2nd? We want to calculate the value of y1. Calculate the value of y1, okay, using what? Euler's method, which value is given at x1, calculate the value of y1. We want to calculate the next value, right? Then how to calculate that? Calculate the value of y1 using Euler's method at x1. Okay. At x1, how to calculate that x1? We know that we have seen in the graph. X1 is equal to x0 plus h. Remember this formula. X1 is equal to x0 plus h. What is the h0? 0 is there. Check that. X0, 0. What is the h? H is given 1. You will get the new value. Is a 1. New value is a 1. Value of y, again y1, value of y1 is equal to, you have to use the Euler's formula. What is the Euler's formula? y0 plus hf into x0 y0. Okay, x0 y0. Okay, again we can write here f of x0 y0. What is this? We know that this given equation x minus x0 minus y0 bracket square. Sorry, y0 square is there. Okay, put this value in that equation. Then I will simplify that equation y0 plus h into x0 minus y0 square. Okay, all of you getting how to get this? Yes, anybody any doubt? No. Okay, good. Then we go for the remaining process or further process. Y0 is equal to what? Again, check that y0 is equal to here I think y0 is given 1 and here it also 1. Okay, we'll check y0 is equal to 1 plus h is equal to again 1, x0 what? 0 minus y0 1 square. Then what is this value? Check that 0 minus 1 square bracket again here bracket. 1 square 1, you will get the minus 1 and plus 1 means you will get the y1 is equal to what? 0. Y1 is equal to 0. And what is the value of x1? X1 is equal to 1. Okay, this is the first iteration value. Okay, in the step 2, you will get the iteration number 1. Iteration number 1. We want to calculate number of iteration, how many? 4 iteration. 4 iteration. Okay, how are you getting up to this? Once you have calculated the step number 2, then some books you have given the step number 3 also. They have written the value or replaced that value with a new value. But guys, no need to replace that value with the old value. Check that. Some books you have given that x1, new x1 and y1, x1 is replaced by the x0, okay, and y1 is replaced by the y0. But here is no need to do that, x1 is replaced by x1, x0 and y1 replaced by the y0. Only you have to use the next formula. Means next means if you have calculated the iteration number 2, then here we want to use the y2 is equal to y1 plus hf into x1 y1. Okay, this formula will be changed. Okay, then again you have to use step number 3, or we can write the step number 3, iteration number 2. Okay, we want to the number of iteration, iteration number 2. Iteration number 2, again check that what is the value. Again calculate the value of y2. Calculate the value of y2 using again same formula, Euler's method. Euler's method at x2. Okay, x2 la kay karayche apala, what we want to calculate for x2 y2 value. Okay, both value we want to calculate using the Euler's method. We know that at x2 is equal to x1 plus h. Okay, here check that when you calculate the x1, then we have taken the x0 plus h, but when you calculate the x2, then we want to use the x1 plus h. Books have, they have replaced this value. Again they have taken here x1 and used the value here x0 plus h. Means they have replaced that value with the help of x0 and y0. No need to do this. Don't confuse. Okay, use this simple method. X2 is equal to x1 plus h is there. What is the value of x1 plus h? X1 we have the value 1 plus h again 1. We will get the 2. Okay, then again we want to calculate the y2. How to calculate the y2? What is the formula? Y1. What is the formula for y1? Y1 is equal to y0 plus hf into x0 y0. What is the formula for y2?
Can anybody tell me? Y1 plus HF. Okay. X1, Y1. Okay. This equation is as it is. X1, here only change that value. I will put directly Y1 plus HF into X1 minus Y1 square. Right? Okay, I'm evaluating this one H into what is the value of Y1? Y1 we have calculated, we are getting 0. H1 is there. What is the value of X1? What is the value of X1? 1 is there. Again we have calculated there. X1 is equal to 1. Minus, again what is the value of Y1? 0 square. Okay. And what is the value of Y2? Y2 is equal to, yes, anybody? You have to make the first multiplication. Okay. Here is a, you will get the 0 plus this 0. Then again, 1 into 1, 1. And x2 is equal to what? X2 is equal to 2. Okay, all of you getting how to calculate? Very simple method. You have to remember only the one part, two formulas in that method. Okay. Then next is a that next iteration number 3. Yes. Anybody tell me next? What is the next step? Fourth number step. Iteration number 3. Yes, anybody tell me how to calculate that iteration number 3. Okay. Again here we want to the calculate which value, calculate the value of yes. YK, okay, using same formula, Euler's method, okay, at what? X3, I will write at X3 is equal to X2 plus H, X2 plus H, what is the X2 value? 2 is there, 2 plus 1 you will get the 3, and value of Y2, Y3 is equal to, you have to modify this formula, Y2 plus HF, X2, Y2. Okay, I will again simplify Y2 plus H into, what is this, X2 minus Y2 square. Okay, put this value, we know that all the values. What is the value of Y2? We have calculated in equation number 2. 1 plus what is the value of x1? Again, what is the value of x2? 2 is there. Minus, what is the value of y2? Again, 1. 1 square. Can you calculate this and how much you will get the y3 is equal to? Check that. 2 minus 1 square means what? 1. 2 minus 1, you will get the 1. 1 into 1, again 1. And 1 plus 1, you will get the 2. And at y, x 3 is equal to what? 3. Yes? And last step, you will get the iteration number. Step number what? 5 is there. Iteration number 4. You want to use that Euler's method or Euler's formula 4 times for number of iterations. We have calculated with f of n is equal to hg minus h0 divided by h. Okay, iteration number 4, what is the value of that? Yes, anybody tell me? Calculate the value of here in a y4 at x4, okay, by using the Euler's method. At x3, at x4 is equal to x3 plus h. What is the value of x3? 2. 2 plus h, 1. 3 is there. Right? Yes, correct. X3 is equal to 3 is there. And this one H is 1, 4, sorry. Okay, and how to calculate the Y4? Y4, I will write that side. Y4 is equal to, yes, anybody tell me, what is the value of Y4? Okay, in that step, we want to the calculate what? Which value? Y4 and X4 and iteration number what? 4. How to calculate that x4? X4 is equal to x3 plus h. What is the x3 value? 3. H is 1, 4. Okay. Value of y4 is equal to, we have to use this equation, modify that equation. Here only plus 1. Okay, y3 plus h, f, x3, y3 is there. Okay, again modify this y3 plus h into, what is the equation? X3 minus y3 square. Okay, put this value in that equation. What is the y3 value? 2 is there. 2 plus 1, 2 plus 1, then x3, 3 is there, 3 minus, again y3, 2, 12, okay, calculate that, see, 3 minus 4, you will get the 2, 2 square means 4, 4 into 1, you will get the again, 3 minus 4, here you will get the minus 1, minus 1 into 1, minus 1, and 2 minus 1, you will get the 1. Y4 is 1. Y4 is 1. Okay, this is the add, we can write, add xg is equal to 4, means what? Y4, the value of yg is equal to 1. This is your answer. Okay, I will be reading how to solve the given difficult with the help of Euler's method. Sometimes you have given the boundary 0 to 4. Okay, 0 to 4. In that case, you don't need to calculate the number of steps. Okay, number of steps or number of iteration value. Today we'll stop here. Next lecture, we will see the Runge-Kutta second order method. And one more method is given, Runge-Kutta fourth order method. Okay, today we will stop here. Thank you.